together this man and woman in holy matrimony, and that state both instituted and approved by Almighty God. After making man, God saw something lacking in man's life that none of the other creation could supply. So he made a woman that she might supply this need, and that together they might find and enjoy happiness. Now, marriage is not a tryout institution, but a union for life between one man and one woman, a union for sharing the affection, joys, problems of life. It is a companionship of sharing life together as one. The husband is to provide for and protect his wife, loving her as his own body, and the wife is to be his helpmeet, the keeper of the home. She is to love, honor, and reverence her husband. Both are to forsake all others and cleave together in sickness, in health, in poverty, or in wealth, till death do them part. Do you both agree to this? Tiffany, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together with him in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful unto him as long as you both shall live? Mason, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together with her in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, be faithful unto her as long as you both shall live? If you would, bow with me. Our most righteous Heavenly Father, we come to you now with this beautiful day and this wonderful union we are about to witness. And Lord, we say this prayer thanking you for the families that have been brought together today. Lord, we thank you for the families of Tiffany and the families of Mason. We pray now especially for these two as they look together to the union of marriage, and as they cleave to one another, that they always look to you for their guidance and for their help, whether they arise a problem, whether they're on top of the mountain or in the valley, that they will love one another, that they will cleave unto one another, that they will forsake all others, and that they will love each other as they love their own bodies. We thank you all for all of this, Lord. We thank you for the ability to have this help need and to have this companion as we go through life. And we say this prayer especially now for Tiffany and for Mason as they undergo this change in their lives, that they would be willing to look to each other and to look to you for all their answers. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Move to the vow part of the ceremony, and I'm going to begin with Mason. Now, Mason, if you would, face Tiffany and take her right hand in yours, and if you would, repeat after me. I, Mason, take you, Tiffany.
I, Mason, take you, Tiffany.
To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For rich or for poor.
For rich or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I do.
I do.
Tiffany, if you would, take Mason's right hand in yours and repeat after me. I, Tiffany, take you, Mason, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for rich or for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, I do. You would bow with me. Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity once again. We pray as we have gone through these vows that they would both take these things to heart, that they would be able to look to you for their guidance as they make this vow between us today, between the assembly of friends and family, and most importantly, Lord, before you, that they will cleave to one another, whether it be in the good times or in bad, that they will love each other, that they will always look to each other for their help and for their comfort. We pray for this union as they move forward in their life, Lord. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Mason, is there a ring? Now, will you, Mason, take this ring like eternity, which is endless, and as the emblem of the purity of your love, place it upon the finger of Tiffany and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With all my heart's affections.
With all my heart's affections.
Tiffany, take this ring, which, like eternity, is endless, and as the emblem of the purity of your love, place it upon the finger of Mason, repeat after me. With this ring, I be wed. With all my heart's affections, I thee endow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Those whom God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Mason and Tiffany, today you are to join your separate lives together. The two separate bottles of sand symbolize your separate lives, your separate families, and your separate sets of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you will ever be as an individual. They also represent the entirety of your life before this moment today. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual container of sand will cease to exist, but will be joined together as one. And just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into their individual containers, so will your marriage be. You would repeat after me in unison, whither thou goest, I will go.
Whither thou goest, I will go.
Where you lodge, I will lodge.
Where you lodge, I will lodge.
Your people will be my people.
Your people will be my people.
And thy God, my God.
And thy God, my God.
For as much as Mason and Tiffany have consented together in holy wedlock, and we have witnessed the same before God in this assembly, by the powers vested in me by God in the state of Missouri, I now pronounce them husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Mason Cockrum.
Thank you all for coming.